Hi, I'm really happy to be here tonight in this space. It's amazing. Thank you, Noah, and thanks everybody for being here. I'm really thrilled, and I'm always thrilled to get to read with my great friend, Nate Fritz. So I'm gonna read some poems from Debacle, Debacle, which is this newest book, and then I'm gonna read a few new things from this crazy long sequence, and I'll talk to you about why it's so crazy a little later. So this is the first poem in Debacle, Debacle. It's called Dear Hell. Once there was a window, and the bathtub was smashing. Once in a meadow, I was fish and a fox. At the moment, I'm in bed, but I ought to be a better friend. At least to the people I'm friendliest with. A barn owl shredding or a free and fair election. You in your bower with the lights down low. I'm not insisting this is anything to sigh at. Time running off with my love to little fanfare. When the curtain's jaw drops, it crushes the house, but also the donkey on fire beside me. Why is it everybody's on fire beside me? And why inside me is the mind always empty or flooded with white so I can't see a thing? I'm sorry to the wizard for stealing his familiar, but also to my family for holding a grudge. Even more so, I'm sorry for not getting the gesture of the girl who shook hands with my hand at the concert, then petted my cheek by the creek at the zoo. I admit, I ate the werewolf, but that wasn't my undoing. I'm the same as ever. You promised to see me soon, and I took you at your word. Black and white camouflage flight suit. And suddenly exhausted, my body saying, stop. How much more clearly uncluttered can I make it? I write my name on the credenza to save it for later, and I write it on a chair so I won't lose my place. If only I could heaven up, but there's still so much to say in the dark. So much hanging over with a gravity upon it. One leaf, call it reddish, falls from a tree. That tree in my yard, the one that needs trimming. The mailman brings me stacks of junk. My shirt is black to hide the sweat. I sweat because I drink too much coffee and ibuprofen for lunch. I ask what I think is a black and white question in hopes we'll see through it to a black and white answer, one fully lit, leaving little room for error. The solution, quite simple, to your heart's awful pressure, lay down your face on the couch-stained couch. Beauty in your mouth as you torch the local paper. When another leaf falls, it is yellow and brown. Yellow and brown, like bananas getting riper. Let it be written. The tree in the front of my house isn't happy. The tree in the back is some version of a maple drifting near the sun. I can hear my neighbor's lawn. Something going off like a rifle. Debacle. I set my alarm, my jaw against the window. Then I sign my name, which is different than writing. Camouflage, camouflage, the day in all its glory. And while I've eaten better pancakes than the ones we made this morning, today seemed prophetic of the rest of my life. So, this next poem is the title poem, Debacle, Debacle. And it's been maybe 4 or 5 years ago now, but I broke my foot in a freak, let there be light accident. poetry accident. And I was emailing back and forth with my friend and editor Nate Pritz, and I'm so glad to like see him. But he, you know, I was feeling sorry for myself sitting on the couch with my foot propped up and throbbing, and Nate was saying to me, you know, take heart, write a poem. Asshole. And then he would say, like, I'm going running. Have a poem for me when I get back. So this is called Debacle Debacle. And it's for Nate. Last week, Coleridge. Yesterday, a haircut. Now I spend so much time sitting, I'm becoming a glowworm, though my fuse is mostly darkness. Positivity these days is difficult to come by, but if you come by, I'm sure we'll have a ball. All I really want is your avalanche rolling, bursting down the mountain to meet me in the meadow. So what if the idea is old? Perhaps it's still a good one, the two of us connected in the buzz of shared experience, the white light to fusion us, the two of us to one of us, and the one of us to natural world, the natural world to the supernatural world, and the supernatural world to the blue black sky, the exploding and collapsing essential idea. Rationally, I realize there's no essential idea, but I nevertheless feel it in all that I experience. My hair turning gray in a pile upon the floor, rat snake through the fingers of the two excited children. My own never stops talking, never stops wanting to push and pull the limits. This book has all the words and wonder when she says it. The leaves, yes, the leaves turning in slow motion and falling in slow motion. Never one single hiccup. Life happens. It's my job to say so. It's our job to express it, expand it to the edges. Essential it is to struggle. But struggle's merely tension, and tension can be a thing of balance, or irritation, confusion, or song. I'm singing in tension with the not singing. I'm living in tension with the forces out to kill me. We're living in tension because we're different human beings, and living in excitement that we're so much the same. The essential recognition is of sameness and difference. And these two together make thoughtfulness pleasure. This week I'm reading a galaxy book. I think of you constantly and try to stay close. To you at 40 from me right now. You're 4 and I'm 40. And it is Friday at 4:40 in September 2010. I've been waiting for this moment to tell you some things, or maybe this moment has been waiting for me. It's hard to know much of anything, but everything seems in perfect alignment, and I am not one to argue with perfection when I can find it, though I do take issue with the way things seem. Here is a grain of salt for you to take. The two of us kicking a ball in the yard. This morning we were running late, and when you couldn't find your rabbit, you cried, so I helped you look for her, but then I couldn't find her either. You took a pony to school to show your friends instead, and I came back to a mountain of work and looking some more for your rabbit. Another cup of black coffee. Another list to check off, this lucky and frustrating life, this stressed out every second, this incredible constant scribble. At breakfast, you made a drawing for me, and we talked about expression. I showed you pictures in a Cy Twombly monograph. You said, those are just like me, and then one of the sculptures you compared to the bones in your arm, and I thought of dinosaurs, but didn't bring it up, and then I showed you the Basquiat drawings. Pointed to one with a coal black face, that's me when I'm angry. And a few pages later, you were tickled by a monster with one pink ear colored pink. Why is that one pink? you asked. And I said, because expressive works aren't necessarily about the way things look, but about the way the artist feels and thinks. You made another drawing with bright, fast strokes. Rabbit exploding with a runway tongue. Devil, blue devil in a suit with a contract. Everything happens so fast, I can't take it. Yesterday is already tomorrow, and the next day, the grass and the leaves on the trees stay green, and then suddenly it's Halloween, it's July, I'm in China, you're in Martha's Vineyard, you're at King's Island. If you're reading this poem, I am 76, or maybe I'm not. You miss me, or I miss you, or we miss each other, even in the midst of being together. It is always this way with people. Call me right away when you get this. So I'm going to read just a few pieces from this new sequence called Radiant Action, which has kind of taken over my life. It's about 110 sections long now. And I don't know if it begins or ends, but I was reading Charlotte's Web to my daughter a couple of years ago, and I'd never read that book. And there's a point in it where Charlotte, the spider, sends Templeton the rat out to get more words for the web so she can save Wilbur the pig from slaughter. And he comes back with an advertisement for laundry detergent. And it says something like, you know, that would even new, more radiant action. And I remember thinking, radiant action is such a fantastic phrase. Like, I just wanted to chew on it. I love that long A, and I love the fact that it seemed to, like, just send its rays and fingers and waves way out into the world. And I wondered how I could take that into other contexts that didn't have anything to do with advertising. So these are from Radiant Action. My inhuman being, adrift in contradiction, why align oneself with anything limited? One can take a whole great lake in one's mouth. The robin in the nest outside my window with her eggs, right now outside my window with her eggs in the rain. Inside, my books break a sweat just to whisper ordinary language, how to do things with words, how to discover the ghost in this machine. Under its skin is a pomegranate seed. We plant it in Afghanistan and grow it up and teach it to read the looks on the faces of children, constellations. The devils are in me, the angels are in me, catfish couches and sweet kerosene in me. My mind crushes everything. I crush a can on everyone. I fall in love in every dream. In every single poem, I die of exposure and heartbreak and aestheticity, that quality of art that reminds us we're alive, that fills us with desire and empathy and light, the engine of beauty, the song of the sublime. In fact, my ears are ringing. I'm at work to wake up typing. The bells of the church up the street care to chime. And later, peppered bacon, I will wrap around a scallop. I will get a good sear on it. I will think about the ocean, the pig in its sty. Anything worth saying can be rendered as an aphorism, might itself be an aphorism, just so you know. My phrase of the moment is radiant action, in love with the sound, in love with the sound, the pulse that beats, the breath that flows, and we'll scream along, the anthem goes until our hearts stop. A very long and radiant action. Sounds deranged, a meaningful noise. Something's going on, but what is it? Sensibility. A disposition to see, to hear, to taste, to smell, to feel about the world in a circle, accommodating opposites, simultaneity, contradiction, disparate impressions. Nature goes wild, which is natural. Why contain it? Chirpy warblers fill the airspace. Chip notes of guitars flood the headphones with tricks. In the end, but a few hands clapping. And generals gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses. Lost my voice in a necessary roughness. The rhyme's so impressive, cause it isn't a grapefruit. Sailboat, loop. Some might hate them, these skittery moments, but I bet they've never wandered the punk rock basements of our breathless blue forests. I bet they've never sung with their brothers and sisters in a harsh, swirling chorus. Beauty is lost on the already dead. Efficiency will never be a value I can live with if you're happy, love the roar of the lion. This is the last one. Thank you so much. All the beautiful places have consequences. All these beautiful worlds, imperfect and rebellious, imperfect but ours. Nucleic acid, nuclear reactors, suns forming suns, forming suns, forming suns. The basements and attics with the sounds of our voices, a singular noise in spite of all division. We are blended to treetops, cinder block streetscapes, cloud shift positions, jays and little chipmunks too nervous to chorus and too numerous not to, too excited not to try. We sway the blue glow of power, two amplifiers, so much elemental turmoil, intensity and love. We could be teenagers, or we could be 40 or 50 or no age at all. What ages mean? All a social construct. The difference is only or mostly a matter of perspective, which is nothing at the human core. Nothing where the passion flames up in multiple meanings, bangs all the particles together forever within and without, and a wildness between us. Energy cannot be destroyed. 25 years and change, 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 but the music still feels like home to me. I'm happy to say, I'm happy to admit it. Hell is a very cold and desolate planet, but oh, so adult. Spruced up and decorous, the cocktails flow with rational business. Even now it's with us, always it is with us, just outside our dear field of vision. Just outside where the light begins to snow, encroaching our freedom, beating down imagination. Clusterfuck, a kind of efficient starvation of the desire to delimit possibility. Your beautiful places, your beautiful vision are not parts of yourself that you should ever relinquish. Paradise is process, intuition, and life. Press your whole body to the ceiling and break it. The limits of your language are the limits of your world. Shake yourself out of yourself like you mean it. Hold out your hand, I will take it in my hand. We can go together to the light. We can stay together in delight, in awe and in terror, in shadow and obscurity. We'll stand the onslaught and beyond good and evil, the radiant crush of our bones and minds, the unpredictable